Disco Elysium is overflowing with political commentary. Some of it subtle, some of it not so much. But there's one tiny throwaway moment that has deeply stuck with me. And it starts off as a joke. You start the game as an amnesiac detective who has forgotten literally everything about the world and himself. You wake up in a trashed hotel room, and you're informed by its proprietor that you will need to pay for the repairs, right after he also explains the concept of money to you.
The IIR, or Interisolari Riel, is the global reserve currency. Whatever part of the world you're in right now, it's safe to assume he means you owe him some money.
This conversation unlocks new dialogue options to unceremoniously ask people for spare change. It becomes a running gag, a joke dialogue option.
Hello, sweetie.
Sweetie needs some money. Like the sarcastic option in Fallout 4, it comes out of nowhere, and the game never really punishes you for doing it. That is, until you meet Joyce, a representative of a board you're investigating. Like no other character you've met so far, Joyce is evidently rich. At every moment, you're reminded that Joyce is part of the upper-class elite. So when you get to investigating her, nested among the questions you should be asking, is a chance to score some dough. Except, here is when the joke stops being funny.
Is what you want to say, but it isn't that easy, is it? Look at that lady. A well-kept, yet tastefully short, bob of dark hair. Despite the first hints of grey, she's elected to keep it au naturel, shaped into a permanent wave, late 40s style. While dull orange pearls hang from her earlobes, red from the cold. Her light green eyes scan you, full of knowledge and worry. Wealth and all its possibilities. Now look at you, you misery-clad simian. Barely able to tie your own laces. Your armpits are late. A scythe of booze proceeds. Your hair sticks to your forehead and your underwear feels uncomfortable. You're poor. You can't ask this person for money. You're too.
Our character is a man who has forgotten everything. Who he is, where he is, what money is, and especially the class hierarchy he exists in. So why can't his mouth force these simple words out?
Shame? You haven't really been in the presence of gentlefolk either, have you? What shame is there to be felt in front of these dock workers, cops, and hotel clerks, but to belittle yourself in these eyes of Odinin?
I think it is shame, because this kind of shame is not just a social boundary, because the shame of being poor is in our bones. It is deeply internalized, and it is cruel. So, although his mind has forgot the world, his body will never forget its place inside it.